गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन इज बेस्ड ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया ड्राफ्टिंग एंड एवोल्यूशन. सो द फर्स्ट इज द ड्राफ्टिंग पार्ट. ऑन द 14th August 1947 मीटिंग ऑफ द असेंबली ऑफ प्रोफेशनल्स अ प्रपोजल फॉर फॉर्मिंग वेरियस कमिटीज वॉज प्रेजेंटेड. सच कमिटीज इंक्लूडेड अ कमिटी ऑन फंडामेंटल राइट्स, द यूनियन पावर्स कमिटी एंड the Union Constitution Committee. On 29th August 1947, the drafting committee was appointed with Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as the chairman along with six other members. Also, now we'll talk about schedules. So the 8th schedule here talks about the official languages. We have the 9th schedule that talks about articles mentioned here are immune from judicial review. The 10th schedule talks about anti-defection provisions for members of parliament and members of the state legislatures. 11th schedule talks about Panchayat Raj, whereas the 12th schedule talks about municipalities, that is the urban local government. Then we have the 4th schedule that talks about the details of allocation of seats in the Rajya Sabha per state. Then we have the 5th schedule, Article 244. Then we have 6th schedule, Article 244 and 275. And then we have the most important schedule, that is the 7th schedule, Article 246, which talks about the union, state and concurrent list responsibilities. Schedules are lists in the constitution that categorize and tabulate bureaucratic activity and policy of the government. We have the 1st schedule from Article 1 to 4. Then we have the 2nd schedule from Article 59, 65, 75, 97, 125, 148, 158, 164 and 186 and 21. Then we have the 3rd schedule, which talks about the list of the oath of offices. Now here the part 12 talks about finance, property, contracts and suit. Part 13 talk about trade and commerce and territory of India. Then we have the part 14, which talks about services under the union, the states and tribunals. Then we have part 15, which talks about elections. Then we have part 16, special provisions related to certain classes. Then we have part 17, languages. Part 18, emergency provisions. Part 19, miscellaneous. Part 20, amendment of the constitution. Part 21, temporary transitional provisions. We have now important parts, that is part 1, union and its territory. Part 2nd is the citizenship. Part 3rd is the fundamental rights. Part 4 is the directive principles and fundamental duties. Part 5 is the union and so on. The constitution in its current form consists of a preamble. We have 22 parts containing 450 articles. We have 12 schedules, 2 appendix and 94 amendments to date. Although it is a federal in nature, it also has a strong unitary bias. Till today we have 104 amendments, and the recent amendment was in 2019 and then was in 2020, that is the CAB. And it is very important in respect of any competitive examination, wherever you sit, for the IAS examination or for judiciary. It's the very important and basic questions which is always being asked. So you should be thorough about it. It's just a basic knowledge about our Constitution of India. The assembly met in sessions open to the public for 166 days, spread over a period of 2 years, 11 months and 18 days before adopting the constitution. This is basically the time which was took to make the Constitution of India. The constitution was drafted by the Constituent Assembly, which was elected by the elected members of the provincial assemblies. Also, the Indian Independence Act 1947 divided British India into two independent states, that is India and Pakistan. This was only after this act where two nations were divided, independent states, that were India and Pakistan. They become independent states after the division. The Cabinet Mission Plan, that was in 1946, British Prime Minister Clement Attlee formulated a cabinet mission to India to discuss and finalize plans for the transfer of power from the British Raj to Indian leadership. as well as to provide India dominance over the states. The provisions of the Government India Act 1935, though never implemented fully, had a great impact on the Constitution of India. Many key features of the Constitution are directly taken from the Act, like example a feudal structure. Acts of British Parliament before 1935, the Government of India Act 1858 abolished the role of East India Company in India government and transferred British India to direct rule of Crown. The majority of the Indian subcontinent was under British colonial rule from 1858 to 1947. This period saw the gradual rise of the Indian independence movement to gain independence from foreign rule. The Constitution of India is the supreme law of India, as you all know that thing. As it is a structure for all other acts which are formed in India, it lays down the framework defining fundamental political principle, establishes the structure, procedure, power and duties of the government institution, and it's the most important part is the fundamental rights. Thank you and have a great day.